Hello friends, welcome back to our channel. So in the previous session we have discussed about the error correction method, that is a Hamming code, so which can identify and detect the one bit errors. So in today we'll see one more example for this Hamming code. So in the previous example we have taken the 4 bits of data, small length of bits. So this Hamming code can identify one bit error in n number of length. Okay, so we can consider the data with n number of length, but it can identify the one bit error. So previously we have seen with a simple problem, that is a data taken with the 4 bits and even parity. Now in this session we will go with one more example, that is the data we will consider with the 7 bits, and then we will find the redundant bits, that is a parity bits, and then we will find the parity bits, the value of those parity bits, and the data sent to the receiver, and the receiver receives with the one bit error, and we can identify the error where the position where the error has been occurred. Right, we'll move on to the problem. So today also we are discussing about the Hamming code, example for Hamming code. So let us consider the data m as 7 bits. Let us take anything 101 1011. So this is the data which is a length of 7 bits, and we have to find out the r such that 2 power r should be greater than or equal to m plus r plus 1. So based upon this condition we have to find out the r. So if you take 3, r is equal to 3, 2 power 3 is greater than or equal to 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 plus 3 plus 1. So 8 greater than or equal to 11, so fails. Now r is equal to 4, so 2 power 4 greater than or equal to 7 plus 4 plus 1, so 16 greater than or equal to, so 12. So this satisfies. So this satisfies means we can consider these redundant bits as a 4. So r can be considered as 4, right? So see, r can be considered as a 4 based upon the expression, 2 power r greater than or equal to m plus r plus 1, right? So now the 4 redundant bits, where we have to place these 4 redundant bits. So we have discussed in the earlier session that these redundant bits should be placed at the powers of 2. So 2 power 0, 2 power 1, 2 power 2, 2 power 4. Right, so the position of this one is 1, so 2 is a 4, and it is 8. So this can be considered as a P1, P2, P4, P8 parity bits. These are the parity bits. So we will consider here, so the total length, we have to add these parity bits to the plain text, that is a data, and this should be sent to the receiver. So the total length of the message will be 7 plus 4 parity bits, that is 11. So we'll consider 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Right? So first position, this is the position, right? So this is the position of parity bits. This is the position of parity bits. Now see, first position P1, fill these positions. Second position P2, fill this one. Fourth position P4, eighth position P8, and fill all the remaining with the data. So here 1 0 1 1 0 1 and 1, right? So this is the data which we have to send from the sender to receiver. Now we have to find out the values of all these parity bits. We have to find out the values of all these parity bits. So here the complete data length is 11. So write down the binary equivalent of all these numbers. So 0 0 0 1 0 0 1 0 0 0 1 1, 8, so 1 0 0 0, so 9, 1 0 0 1, so 10, 1 0 1 0, so 11, 1 0 1 1. So these are the binary equivalent for all the numbers. So we can consider the data of the length of the data. That we, here we are having 11 bits, I mean 11 positions. So we will consider the binary length, binary equivalent for 1 to 11. Now, in order to identify the P1, as we have discussed, so the redundant bits are P8, P4, P2, P1. So P8, P4, P2, P1. Similarly, P8, P4, P2, P1. Right. So in order to find the P1, we have to find all the numbers which are having the P1 value as 1. So here we can observe 1, 3, so this one, 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11. So 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, and 11. So in order to identify this P1, we are supposed to find out the positions of all these things. Now, similarly, P2 means the second position. So second position, come to the second position, P2. So 2, 3. So these are the second positions. 2, 3, 6, 7, 10, 11. So 2, 3, 6, 7, 10 and 11. Similarly, P4. That means fourth position. Here the P4 is the third one, right? So let us consider 1, 2, 3, 4. Right. So 4, 5, 6, 7 positions. 4, 5, 6, 7 positions. Similarly, P8. Let us consider the P8, 8th position. So here you consider the last P8, the 4th bit. So here you can observe 1, 2, 3, 4. That means 8, 9, 10, 11. 8, 9, 10, 11. So here we will consider the even parity. Even parity. So even parity means, so the total number of 1s should be even. Now, we will consider these bits. So, bit in first position is P1, third position is 1, fifth position is 1, seventh position is 1, ninth position is 1, 11th position is 1. So, here you can count the total number of 1s. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, total number of 1s are 5. And here we are considering the even parity, so the total number of 1s should be even. But here it is odd. So P1, if P1's value is 1, that implies the total data will be in an even parity, right? So the total number of 1s will become 6, which is nothing but even. So that's why the P1 can be considered as 1, in order to maintain the even parity. So I hope you understood. So number of 1s are 5, but here we are following the even parity. In order to make this even, we can consider P1 as 1. So the value of P1 should be 1. Similarly, P2. So position at second position. So P2, third position 1, sixth position 0, seventh position is 1, tenth position is 0, 11th position is 1. See, here also you can consider the number of 1s, you can count the number of 1s, which are nothing but odd. So in order to make this even, P2 should be 1. The value of P2 should be 1. So we can consider the P2 as 1. Right. Coming to this one, P4. Take the fourth position, that is a P4. Fifth position is a 1. Sixth position is 0. Seventh position is 1. So here you can observe the number of 1s. The number of 1s for finding P4 is even. So, if P4 is 1, automatically the number of 1s become odd number. So, but here we are maintaining the even parity. So, here we can consider P4 as 0 because it is already even. Similarly, consider P8. So, 8th value So 8th position is a P8, 9th position is 1, 10th position is 0, 11th position is 1. So again, here if you count the number of 1s, we will get the number of 1s as even. So P8 can be 0. Now the redundant bits P8, P4, P2, P1 can be 0, 0, 1 and 1. So these are the values of parity bits. So here we can replace this one, P1 with a 1, P2 with 1, P4 with a 0, P8 with a 0. So this is the data we can send. This is the data we can send, right? So see, so sender finds the parity bits, the value of parity bits, and this data will be sent to the receiver, right? Now if the receiver receives a wrong information, so this is the correct one, and if the sender sends the data as 1 0 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1, so this is a 1-bit error. So here instead of 0, 1 is placed. So this is the data received by the receiver. Now receiver have to find the identify the error and have to correct the error. Now coming to this P1, follow the same procedure. So we have to follow the even parity. That means the number of 1s should be even. So follow the same procedure. The receiver also follows the same procedure in order to find out the parity bits. So the receiver also know about this parity bits, that the position of parity bits are P8, P4, P2 and P1. Right? So that means in the first position, in the second position, in the fourth position and in the eighth position are the parity bits. Now we'll check whether all the data is in even or odd. So again, P1, the first position is 1, third position is 1, fifth position is 1, seventh position is 1, ninth position is 1, and finally the 11th position is 1. So total count, what is the total count of 1s is 6. So this is already even parity, right? Now here P1 is equal to 0. Okay, that means there is no error. Now coming to this P2, second bit, that is 1, third bit, it's again 1, sixth bit, it's again 1. So consider only this one, right? We have to consider only this one, because this process is done at the receiver side. So receiver receives the data in this way. Okay, this is the data received by the receiver. So all these process will be done on this data, right? So the sixth position is 1, not 0. Okay, seventh position it's 1, 10th position is a 0, and 11th position is again 1. So count the number of 1s, so that see here, if you count the number of 1s, it is an odd, but we have to achieve this even parity, so there is some error. So that's why to make this even, the second one must be 1. Let us consider the second parity bit should be 1. Okay, so this is an error. In order to make this even, we have to add some 1, so P2 is equal to 1. Consider P4. So 4th position is 0, 5th position is 1, 6th position is 1, 7th position also is 1. So again, the number of 1s are odd. So that means the parity bit should be make 1 to make this bits as even parity. So consider P4 as 1. And consider this 8, 9, 10, 11. So 8th position, it's a 0. 9th position, it's 1. 10th position is 0, 11th position is 1. So this is already, the number of 1s are even, so it achieves the even parity, the P8 will be 0. Now you can consider P8, P4, P2, P1. So we have, if the data is received perfectly without any error, all these parity bits should get 1, 0. Okay, if all the parity bits got 0, that implies
the receiver receives the data without any error. Okay, there is no modification during the transmission. But here we got two errors. So consider this P8, P4, P2, P1. That means 0, 1, 1 and 0. So this is the Hamming code we got, right? So convert this into decimal. And we have to get the 0 if the data is received perfectly without any error. But we received the data and after calculating this one, we got the parity bits as 0110. Convert it into decimal. So the decimal number is 6. So first of all, if the parity bits got non-zero by calculating, so the receiver will identify that there is an error, right? So the next step is the receiver should correct the error, one bit error. So in order to do the correction, first the receiver should find the position of the error. So where, in which position the data has been interchanging. So for that we have to convert these parity bits into decimal. So we got 6. So that implies the receiver knows that the 6th bit is having some error. So we can observe that every bit is same except the 6th one, except the 6th bit. So automatically the receiver will interchange the value of the 6th bit position. Okay, the bit of the 6th position. So previously it is 1, so the receiver will correct it with 0 such that the receiver receives the data perfectly. Right? So hope you understood this. Another example. So you can consider n number of length, but based upon that length, based upon this condition, we have to find out the position, I mean the number of bits of redundant bits, that means the parity bits. So these R value should be in placed in powers of a 2. So if it is having 5 bits, the power of 2 power 5 is the next one. Next 2 power 6, 2 power 7, the positions. So this will be the positions of redundant bits, right? This you have to remember. So R will be in the powers of n. Okay, n. Powers of n. Right? So hope you understood this one. So let us stop here. So this is the error correction mechanism. So the receiver will identify the error and also correct the error. So identify and the receiver knows about the position where the data has been interchanged, and the receiver will find out that and that position, and the receiver will interchange the bits. So either if it is 0, it will be changed to 1. If it is 1, it will be changed to 0. So this is how the Hamming code works. So this is, once again I'm telling, so this is the mechanism for finding the 1 bit error. So identify and correction of 1 bit errors, right? So let us stop here. So if you are having any doubts regarding this Hamming code, so feel free to post your doubts in the comment section. So that definitely I will try to clarify all your doubts. And if you really understood my session, like my sessions, share my sessions with your friends, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. So thanks for watching. Thank you very much.